we're pretty much ready to go.
For Andy Basich, maintaining an energy-efficient camp is key to his lifestyle along the Yukon River. Today, he and Denise will convert his artist yurt into a structure that relies only on solar power, a task that will benefit from the endless summer daylight.
I want to be as independent from the world as I can be so that I can free myself from having to burn a generator just to charge a cell phone or turn on lights. Electricity is sometimes hard to comprehend. It's kind of one of those mystery things in the world that everybody uses it, but really not too many people understand how it works. So Denise really needs to understand very intimately how the off-grid system works.
The elevator is an impressive machine here. The size, the thought, every aspect of it, what it took to create that, build it, put it in place, and one person doing it. Whoa, it looks like it's gonna bind. That does not sound good.
If worst comes to worst, you can be the person who has to climb down the cables to fix the elevator.
What? Worst comes to worst. Oh, hear that creaking? Going up in the elevator is a little bit breath-holding for me. Listening to the elevator grinding and creaking when it's pulling under a load.
Close foot.
Okay, get off. Oh, shit. Well, I gave up holding the panel, I must say. I was holding myself for the last part.
One thing great about the interior of Alaska where I live is we have 20 hours of solar charging here for a good part of the summer. So much of nature is free. All you got to do is take the time and energy and use a little technology to get it. Bring this one in and tie it to this one.
Okay.
I've taken what I have on my main property for my power grid, and I've shrunk it down, and I've simplified it as much as I can, and that's what I want to have at the artist yurt. Utilizing the sun for power, getting it for free.
Black is the hot.
And white is?
White is neutral.
Except for when you go to DC. When you go to DC, then black is negative and red is positive. Just like in your car or truck or boat or whatever.
To me, electricity, there's a lot of mystery to it. I understand some of the basics of it, the basic physics of it, and just enough to know that it can be dangerous.
Everything's connected here now. Except for we need to connect our red battery terminal up to the positive.
And what could potentially happen?
Everything could go poof.
Everything could go poof.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Ready, Andy. Don't do that!
What did I tell
now
you?
Now it's really gonna happen and I'm not even gonna react.
If Peter cries wolf too many times, now we're at the moment of truth. If everything goes well, I'll very rarely ever have to turn a generator on here again to power this place. You want to turn on the breaker?
Yeah, let me do it. Ready?
Up.
One, two. Okay. That's good.
Yay, we got light.
Perfect. Putting in an electrical system, for me to be part of it now while he's developing it and putting it in, is a fabulous opportunity to learn it.
Why don't you finish this right here?
Okay, last one.
All you gotta do on this one,
yes,
like the other ones, take this wire, red to red, black to black.
Okay.
All you gotta remember there is red is hot, black is
Negative.
Everything's off right now, right?
Yep.
Anytime you build something yourself, you have a much greater understanding than if someone just builds it for you. And so I thought if Denise came and saw where the wires are going, the different components, it would help her to understand where the power comes from, how it's routed, and how to control it.
Okay. Red to red, black to black. Ready for DC. Ta-da! It works. Big test was right at the end, turning on the light that I wired up over the bed, and big A, 100% on that test.
This is all ready to go, but this is perfect. Everything looks like it's working just fine. I didn't melt anything. My hair isn't sick and straight up.
It's been a really interesting, empowering experience getting solar power harnessed into an electric system over at the yurt. A lot more to learn, but I can get by with what I've got and add to that and keep learning.
I think what I want to do is anytime people come here, I want them to have leave something behind of who they are. I was thinking about having them like etch their names into the stairway or one of the posts or something like that. But I really want is people to leave a piece of their art, whether it's music or poetry or writing or drawing, whatever, painting.
Wow.
It's a pretty good height.
Really good spot. Basically, that was dead sticks. Look what you did with it.
We've got a beautiful place in the artist yurt. All we really needed was to be able to power it off-grid. Got some solar panels, got some really good batteries, got a great system, and we're up and running and completely independent there now.
Better try out this bed and make sure that it's comfortable.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Are you sure? It's been a long day.
Oh, yeah. Okay, you can turn out the lights now. See your hand.
Ah!
There you go.
Good night.
Perfect.